Hi, my name is Jean Rockman from Atlanta, Georgia. I want to welcome everybody to Rockman Wealth Channel. I am so happy that you came back and checking us out because we tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, keeping it real each and every day. For who? For you. Listen, I am so thankful to all you guys for your fan mail, for going to Facebook and looking me up and becoming my friend on Facebook. Make sure you go to Facebook, look for Jean Rockman, as well as go to Wealthy Women Enterprises, Wealthy Women Enterprises, and like my page there too. For all the women that's putting it down and wearing the crown, go to my page and like it so we can keep you informed. Listen, I want to share something with you guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Did I say subscribe? Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe right now and give me a thumb up, okay? Want to make sure I said that. Talking about Will Smith wisdom. I have watched that video over and over and over again, mainly because, you know, I'm all about information and inspiration. That's just my spirit. But also, too, some of the diamonds in our company, like Mr. Ed Hartley, he talked about, you know, Will Smith talking about him getting on a treadmill and he'll die on a treadmill before you outdo him, you know. And I watched the whole video, guys, because this is my journey to becoming a diamond. I'm already a diamond. I was a diamond the day I was born. But a diamond in OG is the number one lifestyle in the world. When you got God, number one. And then being a diamond in organic gold, our company is setting records like never before. And so I am so happy to be a diamond myself and to bring it to you live and in living color. What I want to share with you is about Will Smith wisdom. Now, he talked about not being afraid to die on a treadmill. What did he mean by that? He talked about basically not being afraid to die for what you believe in and not being afraid to, you know, go for what you know. If you believe that you're in the right opportunity at the right time, be willing to do all that it takes. People can have more skills than you, to be more talented than you. They may, you know more people, have a greater center of influence, but that don't matter. Like I said, facts don't matter when you have a dream. It don't matter. If you got an incredible work ethic and as well as you're following the system that's in place, staying in plug with the leadership, hey, you're gonna win too. So he talked about, he said that if someone got on a treadmill next to him and they was competing against him, that he said two things are gonna happen. Either they're going to get off the treadmill first or he's gonna die. Meaning that this man is gonna keep on making it happen. It don't, regardless of what it looked like, regardless of what that person think, he's not gonna stop and he's willing to die for what he believe in. And that's what you have to do. Then he talked about represent an idea, the possibilities. You really can make what you want and you can create what you want. This is one of the things that my leaders taught me about having your goals and keeping it with you and putting it on cards. I look at this as my daily vitamin after I pray and do my meditation. I look at this as my daily vitamin. This is my affirmations that I put on, but I even got it laminated. And I take it with me everywhere I go. I keep it with me everywhere. And every time I think about it, like I heard one of my leaders say, you know, treat it like a vitamin. Take four times a day. Every time I see it, I read it. I say it with emotion. I say it as though it already exists. I'm excited. I'm grateful and thankful for all that God is doing for me because I know it's done. It's like the difference between pre-playing and replaying. A lot of us today stay in our broke down conditions because we keep replaying the past. We keep remembering what we went through in the past and, you know, what happened in our families. And all of us got a story. Every last one of us on the planet Earth been through something. But what it is now is whatever your condition is, it don't have to be that way. That's residuals from the past. Now all you have to do is stay focused on what it is that you want it to be and continue to pre-play the future and you'll walk into it. So that's what he talked about, belief. You have to believe first before anyone else. You got to believe in your goals with all your gut, all your fiber, all your being that is going to be done. And it don't matter what other people think about you. It don't matter what people say. It don't matter what people say. Oh, this person, all they do is talk. All they do is, it don't matter. Look, let me tell you something. The minute I said I was going to be a diamond, it was already done. Now I'm just walking into it. And I'm having a great time doing it because before, I'm just being real candid, or as we like to say, transparent. I'm being real transparent. Before you know, in my organization, I told you I'm with Organo Go, one of my ventures, you know, besides owning my own tax and financial company, this is where I'm building up my lifestyle. I used to get a little bit, you know, irritated or agitated if someone hit a pin position before me. I would get so livid. I'd be like, man, why they doing it faster than me? I mean, I'm skilled, I'm talented, I know what I'm doing. Why they going there before me? But you know, now I'm so excited when a person goes sapphire, ruby, emerald, diamond. I'm so excited because I'm excited for them because they got it done and I see myself standing next to them. So now every time somebody else is going and hitting their position, I am so, so excited about them hitting their positions. You understand what I'm saying? Because I know I am there also. So that's what I'm gonna encourage you. Don't worry about what other people are doing. Don't worry about what other people say. You just stay focused. Let me get some more tips on what Will Smith said, okay? This is my interpretation. He said about our thoughts, our feelings, ideas of physical in the universe. That was one that I was very, very excited about our ideas being physical in the universe. What does that mean? I look at our ideas and our thoughts as the seed and the universe as the ground. That whatever you put out there, thoughts are live, breathing, real things, guys, that you got to be careful what you think about, because what you think about, you bring about. And a lot of people don't realize that every time they keep thinking about what they don't want, they bring on more and more of what they don't want instead of focusing on what they do want. And I know sometimes it can be hard, especially when you're in the fight, especially when you're in the fire and you're going through it and you're like, man, when is it gonna happen? But listen, I want to challenge you to go on this 21-day fast with me to only focus on what you want, to focus on what you need, to focus on what it is that you want to have, guys. I want you to take that challenge with me. Get your pictures, get your magazines, make a vision board, put everything up there that you want and look at it three or four times a day. And I want you to make sure that you just continue to believe that it will happen. What I want to do is I'm gonna come right back and give you part two of my thoughts about Will Smith wisdom. Okay, so stay tuned.